And there has been this incredible solidarity of people from, of all stripes and all walks of life. Yet there are very real concerns and questions about assimilation of immigrant groups moving forward, about immigrant communities and how you deal with them and what happens now.
Absolutely. I mean, the first thing you have to remember as well is that our borders are so easy to cross. I mean, to get to Belgium is about as easy to go from New York to Connecticut. So there is a big concern about that. But at the same time, that will fuel the right wing, who already don't want more immigrants coming in, the Syrian war, the refugees. So we've got to be very careful in France. It's a very fragile time of reaction.
But that's immigration.
Extremism.
Anderson had people over his shoulder before I joined him who were in a very heated debate here. And they were all obviously French locals to this neighborhood. And they were having the debate about how these immigrants who are now here, how they have been disenfranchised. And that that these brothers were a function of that. That was
absolutely
the aspect of the argument.
Absolutely.
That the state didn't embrace them, didn't give them what they needed.
Doesn't.
So they were prey to radicalization.
Absolutely. What happens is that, in fact, they're not immigrants. They were born in France.
Right.
They're French. And there are so many young Muslims like that who grow up in the suburbs outside of Paris, which are very grim. Their opportunities are very, very bleak. People don't believe me, but it's very difficult for them to get apartments, jobs, education. If to make it out of the world in which the brothers grew up in, you need to be highly motivated, highly driven. And
not to suggest that a reasonable alternative is terrorism.
Absolutely not. I'm not saying that. But what I do think is that there must be a way for France to begin to assimilate the Muslim population, which is, by the way, as you know, the largest in Europe.